Before we start getting into the avatars today, what I want to do is change how I want to add these images, so our settings images, to a new folder. So if we head over to the text editor and we open up the public storage images folder, I want to create a new folder and we're going to call it settings. And then we're going to take these two images, which is our icon and our background image, and we're going to put it in the settings folder. Okay, now that that's done, we need to change install command. So Voyager admin install, move this over a little bit. What we can do as well is we can bring this up. Let me copy paste, and then we'll just bring this up here so that we can have our handle method be part of our confirm command. So if this confirm, this load defaults. Now we can get rid of this and this. And now we can also take this and bring it up here. And now that should still work the same. We'll try it in a bit, but let's go ahead and change the other things first. Let's take this. I want to slide it over. So basically what we want to do now is we want to take these folders, pages, posts, and users, and also add them to our main thing here. So basically we just want to take this one, and then we're going to copy them and also add them to that images folder. So basically we just want to make sure that all of our stock images that we're keeping throughout the app are in this images folder, and then we're just keeping them separate based on what they are. And when you have your own projects, you can delete these or whatever you want to do with them, but at least we're going to keep them in here for now so that we can make sure we have them throughout the app. So now this file directory, we are going to delete, we're going to copy. And so let's check our storage folder and see what's in here. So in here, we're going to get rid of pages and posts as well. So we'll say pages, posts, because when we reinstall it, it's going to be coming from this public folder. So now this we can change to an array. Then we'll open that up. And now this can be moved up. And then we'll just add a comma here. Okay, so copy, paste, paste. And then we can, oh, and we also need settings. So copy, paste. And settings. That's it. Our copy directory, we're going to be doing storage, images, settings. And now this is going to be going to storage settings. So then when we reinstall, we'll have a new folder. And instead of it being in the images folder, we'll have it down here in our public folder. Okay, so images, settings. The next one is pages. And then we'll copy and paste this one. Posts. And then avatar will be the same and users will be the same. Okay, so one more time, let's just go through this really quick. So basically, we've taken the default dummy data that came with Voyager install, with the main Voyager install. We've copied them and we've added them to this images folder. Okay, so now we have pages and posts. We have separated our settings, our background image and our vault icon image, and added them to a new folder. So now that when we run the Voyager admin install command, we're going to delete from the storage folder, storage public, we're going to delete the settings folder, we're going to delete the users, pages, and posts. The only one that we're keeping is the images folder. And everything will be copied over into their own distinct folders. So one thing we also want to do is when you transfer this to a server, you chances are haven't run your storage link command. So here you can write this call storage link. And that'll create the link between our storage folder and our public folder. Okay, so that should be good. Copy success. All of that should be the same. Okay, fantastic. Now, this settings table Cedar custom, we do need to reconfigure some of the options in there. So settings table Cedar custom. And we just need to change the images. So the new background image will be in public storage, images. It'll be in our new folder, which will be settings. Okay, and the same for the vault icon will be settings. So why don't we go ahead and run this and make sure that we have everything that we need. So the command is php artisan voyager admin install. Let that run. Okay, this will delete. So that means that our handle method is being called correctly. And then we're going to say yes. Because we installed Laravel the way that we did, we already have a storage link. But this is just in case we don't have it. Okay, and now if we refresh our list, and let's close this up, we have images, avatar pages, posts, settings, and that's in our images folder like it's supposed to be. And then we have our new folder, settings, and then if we head down to the storage public, we have settings. Cool. So now everything should work correctly, and this should all be the same. So refresh. Cool, we didn't break anything. Fantastic. So now let's go ahead and first take a look at the avatars. So we're going to log in as an admin, admin@admin.com, password. Okay, and we still have our images. Cool. The way that Voyager handles uploading an image, it uses intervention image, which is a package you can take a look at, but I'll leave the link for Voyager in the description again, and then you can go ahead, take a look and see what packages it uses. But it does use intervention image. And what that does is it sort of customizes all of the uploads that we do. It's a really good package for cropping and just sort of maintaining size, and just there's a lot that can be done when it comes to images. This is how it uploads our stuff. And when a user changes their image through this admin panel, it creates a new folder. So let's give that a try. If we go to, let's try it right from our admin profile. Okay, now if you go to edit my profile, you go to choose file, and you go ahead and just pick an image, open, and then save. Now there is a bit of a disconnect between Voyager and our front end. So if we were to go to home, that'll take us back to our Laravel front end. Now, because we have already logged in on the Voyager side in the back end, we're already logged into our Laravel front end. So if we click dashboard, we'll head straight to the dashboard page. However, the Jetstream package needs a specific thing to be set in order to get the profile photos. Okay, so if we go back to the text editor, let me drop some of these. Okay, the first thing we need to do is set it up in our config. So config Jetstream. Okay, and if you head all the way down to the bottom, you have to enable the feature. There is has profile photos. Now, this has profile photos. If we go to our user model, this has profile photo is being called on our user model already. So there's nothing that we need to do there. Okay, so let's go back, refresh the Laravel front end. Now you can see we have Jetstream's default profile image. So if we go to the profile settings here, you can see that you can select the photo and then it'll change it. So let me show you where this is even coming from. We head back over to the text editor in this trait right here. Okay, so let's go to it. You'll see the different methods, the different functions that are being called. So we have update profile photo, and this will save, once we save it, it'll save it to our profile photos folder. And there are a whole bunch of functions in here that can be called from the app in order to address all of these. This one is what I'm talking about. This is a default profile photo. And if you take a look, this is the image that we're being shown. It's coming from a site called ui-avatars.com. It's just using their API. It's encoding the name and it's giving it a color with the background, and that's basically what we're seeing right here. Now, in order to customize this, what we're going to have to do is we can actually take this whole trait and just copy and paste it into our own app, because this is in the vendor file. So we're going to copy this one. We're going to come up to our app, and right in the app, we're going to create a new folder and we're going to call it traits. Okay, and then we can go ahead and paste that in. Now we need to change the namespace here. So it's going to be app traits. And then in our user model, we need to call that new one. So this one will be app traits. Okay, so now we can close this one. And now to test that this is working, we can just get rid of all of this. And now we're just returning an empty string. So if we go back to the browser and refresh this, this should now just be empty. And as you can see, now there's nothing left. This is just the alt that goes on the image element. So now let's head back. For now, we're just gonna put that back. To make this work all together, we actually need to change. Let's open this up. Open up our database. And if we head down to the users table, if we take a look here, okay, so this is the avatar field that we have here, and this was added on with the Voyager install. So as you can see, this is the user that we changed, which is the admin, and this is the route to that image. But if we head over to the right, you'll see that we also have a profile photo path. Now, this is a conflict with Voyager and Laravel that we need to address. The easiest way to do this would be to head down to our own database, migrations. This is a users table. This photo profile photo path, let's just comment it out. You can get rid of it if you need it. Certain things I like to keep, and in case I need to go ahead and change it back, I know exactly what the values are. So I'm just going to comment it out. We need to run our install command again so that I can drop all the tables and reseed them. Okay, this will delete. Are you sure? Yes. Now if we go ahead and refresh the table and we go to the end, you see there's no more profile photo path and we still have our user's default. Okay, so the first thing that I want to do is display our user's default. So in here we can just do asset and then it'll be storage, images, avatar default.png. Okay, let me move this up. And now let's go ahead and log in again. admin@admin.com, password. Okay, so now we have our default. But the problem now is if we go ahead and try to change the image and save, we now no longer have this profile photo path, which means we also need to change some things in this trait here. If we go all the way up to the top now, anywhere where it says profile photo path, we can now change to avatar. Find all of them. Okay, and now we can just change that to avatar. Okay, so let's try to save this image again. So refresh, select a photo, select the image, open, save. Okay, it looks like it went through. So we have one there, we have one there. Now let's take a look and refresh this down. Well, the other problem now is that it's also saving to our profile photo because that's where it's normally supposed to store it. What we want to do is change the... We want to change this to use what Voyager uses, and that's a different path. Okay, so how we can... So we can do that by creating a new variable. We'll say image underscore path equals. And then we'll say users... date, and this is just PHP. So F for the full month, and then year for the full year, dot in quotations, single quotations, we're going to have another slash. Where this profile photos is, that's what this folder is. So we're just going to go ahead and change that to image path. So now let's give this a try again. Refresh, select a new photo, and we'll pick this one. Open, save. Okay, so that took. Now we have a users with a July folder, and if we open up that image, okay, we have the image right here. Let's close that out. Now we can go ahead and close this Voyager admin install, and we can also close the migration. And we can also close the user and Jetstream. And so we'll just work in here. Now let's go ahead and log into our admin side. Our image has been changed in here as well, and here. So if we open that up and go to the profile, and then we click edit my profile, and then change the image in here, and let's say we'll click this one, open, and save. Okay, you can see we have the image here, but we've lost our image here. let's go ahead and fix that. So the reason for that is because if it's looking for the previous, it looks for, you know, the previous photo, which was the default. But what it does is it deletes the previous. So we need to do a little bit more of a check in here. So if previous equals users default.png, or actually, we need to say if it does not equal users default.png, then we can go ahead and do it. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and run that install one last time. This way we make sure all of our files are clear. And before I do that, I want to get rid of this folder too. So if we open up our Voyager admin install, copy overs, so we can just do copy paste. And then this will be storage profile photos. I think it is storage profile photos. Okay, so now we can go ahead and run it. Then we say yes. Okay, so now if we take a look, that folder is gone, that profile photo, and then if we open up users, we have our default image. So let's go ahead and first here, we'll refresh it. Well, we can refresh both of them. Go log in, admin at admin.com, password. Okay, and then we'll go over to the profile page. Okay, we'll select a new photo. Save. Okay, so we have our image up here. Let's go over to the admin side now. Refresh. And while that's refreshing, let's just take a look real quick. You see now we have users, July, and we also still have our default image. And so let's go back to the browser. Okay, our image is in here. Go to the users table. Okay, and now we have our new image and we still have our defaults in here. Let's go ahead and edit this image. Use file. Select another one. Open. Save. Great, so we have our new image. We still have our defaults. And if we take a look at our folders over here, go ahead and refresh these. Okay, you see we still only have the one image. So we want to make sure that it's this one now. Great, it is. So now we've successfully connected the Jetstream images with the Voyager admin images, and now we're good to go. I'm going to leave it there for now. I'm going to make sure to push all the code up to GitHub. I will leave a link down in the description for you guys to take a look. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.